Australia's most controversial doctor might never operate on our shores again after a medical committee found him guilty of unsatisfactory professional conduct. Dr. Charlie Teo says he accepts the finding. It will see him banned from operating without the written permission of another neurosurgeon.
I have to take that on the chin and, you know, make sure that that never happens again.
The world-famous neurosurgeon is the focus of this week's Spotlight investigation, which reveals how Australian patients have been forced to travel overseas for life-saving operations. Joining me now is Spotlight host Michael Usher. Good to see you, Michael.
Yeah, good to see you.
You've been working on this for quite some time. Mm. You spoke exclusively with Charlie Teo after that verdict yesterday.
Yeah.
How's he feeling about potentially never operating in Australia again?
Look, he's gutted by that, but the conditions on his operating licence were in place already, so that needing permission of another neurosurgeon was already there, and in fact, in a small win, they've reduced the years of qualification on that other neurosurgeon from 20 years to 15 years. Minor point. Still makes it very difficult for him. He has handcuffs on in this country. He's shattered, mostly shattered for his patients. He concedes the misconduct charges. He said he's not going to, you know, object to that. He still disputes the finer points of it. He may well appeal that, but the process involved here is years and very expensive legal sort of to the Supreme Court and everything else. So he's upset. He's more upset for his patients that he just can't help anymore.
Well, that's the point, isn't it? Because the patients are the ones now that have to seek his services elsewhere. What are they going to do?
Well, some of them don't know what they're going to do, and some of them just will not be able to have any more surgery. So we've spoken to a few of his patients, two in particular, that are now travelling to Europe, to Spain, to receive the treatment there. Now, Charlie can go there and he can supervise it. They are surgeons that use his technique, this minimally invasive keyhole surgery. But for some of them, it is very sadly the end of the road. I mean, one young mum, Elise, we've spoken to, she's on her fifth or sixth brain surgery with Dr. Charlie Teo. That won't be possible anymore for her. Mm. Australian patients having to go overseas to get treatment because the surgeon they choose is banned from Australian hospitals. Charlie can operate. He has a licence. No hospital in Australia will open the door to him right now.
Well, that's a really good point, isn't it? Because he can operate if he gets the written permission by another neurosurgeon.
Yeah.
Does he have any allies in this industry?
That person's a unicorn.
Right.
At this stage. So no, he doesn't. Charlie's a maverick. I put to him in the interview that it strikes me that he's his own worst enemy. Charlie has a big ego on him. He's very strident in his views. He's a maverick in what he's done.
Mm.
He goes where no other surgeon will go. I mean, if you're end of life and there's no other chances and the neurological community here in Australia say, look, we don't want to touch you, Charlie will, and he'll give it a go. So he's feeling very deeply for his patients. In his words, it sounds very strong, but he's standing by them. He believes that thousands of Australians will die because of this decision against him.
Mm. A lot of those patients have no other choice. Michael, good to see you
again. Good to see you, Charlie. Thank you.
Can't wait for the show. And you can watch the full episode of Spotlight this Sunday at 8:50 p.m. on Channel 7 and 7+.